If you are collaborating with your team in Airtable, you must understand how to share access to interfaces. This is one of the most advanced features inside of Airtable, making it so that you can collaborate better and also that you have full control over what your teammates see, edit, delete, all of the above. If learning about this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to unlock the full potential of your no-code software. Airtable is one of our favorite tools in the no-code space, and in this video, I am breaking down how you can share access to your interfaces in a way that gives you full control over what people see and edit, etc. Before we hop into the heart of the video, though, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. Airtable is a complicated software, and if you don't really understand the fundamentals of it, you're not going to be unlocking its full potential. This is exactly why I put together my Airtable crash course to teach you all of those key features so that you can get the most out of the tool. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and I'll send it to you for free. Now, without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things. I have before me my Airtable interface that I just created called Sharing OKRs. Now, I created this using the app Quick Start function with Airtable. I just went in and clicked a few things. It took all of 5 seconds, super easy to get set up. Now you can see on the left here, what we're looking at is an interface, not to be confused with the data. The data inside of Airtable, these are the tables and the linked relationships and all the different fields and all of the different formulas, all of the stuff behind the scenes that's going on. We are, however, in interfaces, this little place right here, and this is where we can control how people view that information. Here we have information on this nice little list. If we drop into budget, we're going to see another list view here. We can drop into expense tracking and we see more of a grid view here. And then over here in categories, right? So we've got all these different interfaces that were automatically created for us. And each one is uniquely crafted to show specific information. Now, I'll let you build on your own time all the different things with interfaces. What we need to talk about is how to share this access. Now, when we first install any kind of new interface, we're going to be in a vision or a view that looks like this, where it's editing. It allows us to edit and change the layout of the interface, what people can see, etc. So before we can ever share an interface, we must first publish it. We can click any interface where we made new changes to it and then publish those changes so that anybody who has access is going to see the updated version. Now that we've published our interface, we can start to share it. So in the bottom corner here, we can click on share. And here we get asked what interfaces we want to share. So it's very important that we understand the structure here because we have the ability to share just an interface or all of those interfaces. Now, the thing that we cannot control is what happens inside of the interface. So let's first identify what this is. Budget here is the interface. There are 5 interfaces, OKRs being the first one, tasks being the fifth. But I'm looking at budget, the second of the 5. And inside of budget, I've got 3 different pages. These interface pages, we cannot share one page within the interface. If we share budget at the high level, we're sharing all of the pages inside of it. This is a very important takeaway for you as you're sharing your interfaces because it will dictate how you build your pages and in how many interfaces. You're not limited to the number of interfaces that you might want to build. However, when you share an interface, if I share budget, I'm sharing all 3 pages, full stop. Now, back to the sharing down here in the corner, I can choose which interfaces I want to share. So if I just want to share budget, no problem. Or if I want to share budget programs and projects, I can do that too. Now I can choose to add people here via email, and I can also choose what type of access they will have. I can share read-only access and not incur a charge. This is very important because it means that I can share stuff and not worry about increasing my bill with Airtable. However, I am limited to what those people can do inside of the software. They can just see stuff. They cannot edit, they cannot comment, so it's really just read-only. If I want to give them access to be able to comment on records and or edit data inside of the interface, then they must be paid users. And when I go to add them here, I will incur a charge on whatever plan I am on. So if I'm on the $20 a month plan, that's what I'm gonna pay for that new user every month that they're active in my interface. So that is it. Everything you need to know about sharing interfaces inside of Airtable, making sure that you give people the exact access that you want them to have. I know we went quick, so any questions you have, be sure to drop below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.